Hey guys, welcome back to another new video. And today we are going to be taking a look at how to get a really expensive looking shot for very cheap. And how are we gonna do this, you ask? Come with me. Follow me to my office. All you're gonna need is a camera and a tripod, okay? Those are the two things you're gonna need. Obviously there's lighting and all that extra shit, but we're just talking about how to get that movement that you guys saw in the video. So actually, you know what? Hang on, I'll take this off and I'll show you what tripod I'm using. All right, I know this video is a little sporadic, but we're just gonna roll with it. So this tripod right here, this is the Manfrotto 190 Go. It is a $600 tripod, but this isn't the exact one that you need. You just need to have a tripod that has the same function that this one has. And you can actually get them online for about 150 bucks now, rather than going and splurging on a $600 tripod. For full transparency, I don't own this. I borrowed this off a friend, and I'm gonna return it, maybe, if they ask for it. If they don't, I'm keeping it. So I know I mentioned a specific function that the tripod needs to have. It has a sensor that actually comes up like this, and I can tilt it this way. So what's the point of this? So let me tell you, kind sirs, this actually lets you get overhead shots. So now if I put the camera back onto this, the camera is going to be facing down this way. And that's pretty much all you're going to need to get the shot that you guys saw. I'll put some on the screen, like maybe here or in the description as well, for alternatives to this tripod. Because I saw heaps of videos about this one particular shot and I was like, it looks so cool, but I can't go around spending $300 to $500 on a tripod. I'll put some in, actually, I've been looking at them, I'll put them in the description. Because they're probably the ones that I'm gonna look into getting once I do have to return this tripod. They go for around 150 bucks, and I think that's pretty fair for what they're offering. So you've seen the gear, you've seen the setup in terms of what the tripod needs to look like when you actually shoot it. Now let's go into how to actually pull off the shot. Let's go!
Yaga, flash forward. I have a haircut. Very good. This is definitely the same day. I'm recording on my phone currently. Sorry for the audio because I don't have a second camera at the moment, so please bear with me. So I've just created a setup. I'm gonna show you the setup that you need to do with this tripod, how to do the movement, and then we'll move on to like post-production and like stuff you can do later on to actually get it to look like chef's kiss. Good.
All right, I'm gonna set you boys down here.
Loosen this, bring this up like that, pull it down like this, pull it through. You can do this kind of stuff with cheaper tripods, and also it definitely looks possible if you want to make a rig out of like PVC pipe. It just takes a bit more work, but here we go. This back handle here, you gotta fold it back up just to give you more room.
Yeah, I'm gonna move you just so you can get like a better view on everything.
Your two prongs, your two legs, what you can do is rest it beside the item, just like that. The main thing you really have to be careful with when doing this kind of shot, at least for me, is the legs not getting in shot. Move this a little closer, and then now when I raise it up, you don't see the legs at all. Very good, that's pretty much all it is. So you're just gonna make sure the legs aren't in shot. You can have them a little bit like this, just the edges in shot, because we're gonna fix some of it in post.
All right, I'm gonna pack down this bich, and I'll see you guys in a second. So now that you guys have learned how to do the movement and like how to set up the tripod and that kind of stuff, let me quickly run you guys through the editing phase. Going through, you're gonna notice that I actually haven't done too much to this clip to get it to look right. That makes sense. So I've actually edited this as an Adobe After Effects composition. All I did in After Effects was I painted out the wire that was actually connected to the back of the ball. I've nested that again because here I've actually wanted to mess around with the speed a little bit. So it starts at 100% and then drops down to about 58%. We get rid of this, and now we have our final part of the clip, and that's just going to be our scale and position. So up here you can see that I've started the clip at 213. So from here, so it starts at 213, then goes down to 110, and then at the very end it goes down to 100, so we have our full clip. If I show you what the original positioning looks like, you can actually see that the camera wasn't perfectly positioned on top of the glass. So that's actually why I've zoomed it in like this. And also that's why it's so good to film this in 4K. I don't have a 4K camera yet, so this is actually still in 1080. If you have a 4K camera, please use it. Your shot will turn out a lot nicer than mine. And that's it. That's all I did for the shot. It's super simple, super easy. The end, I've added in a bit of smoke on the bull's nose. And that's just a smoke element that I got off of a stock footage website. And I've just whacked it on top, resized it, keyed out the background, and Bob's your uncle. Dennis is your dad. Yeah, that's the final shot, guys. There's not really much else for me to go over. If you guys have any more questions, leave them in the comments below. Until then, let's get to the outro. Alright, that's it guys. Thank you so much for watching. I'm sorry if this video's been kind of sporadic and all over the place. It's been a crazy few weeks, but I really appreciate you guys sticking around. I hope you guys learned something. Please leave any questions that you have for me in the comments below. If you have any cool video ideas, I'd love to take some of your ideas and actually bring them to life. I think that'd be a really cool series to do. And be on the lookout for new videos soon. I am not going to leave you guys hanging for another few months. My upload schedule is going to get better as time goes on. So yeah, stick around. I'm gonna get you guys more consistent content because you know what? You deserve it. You're loyal. You're beautiful. And again, thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you guys in the next video. I love you. Bye.